Played for over a decade in the NFL. Five for the Saints, couple Dolphins, Lions, Bills, Niners, Super Bowl champ back in 2009. Number two pick out of USC. One of the most dynamic college football players of all time as part of our new Fox Saturday college football broadcast.
Yes.
With Urban Meyer, Matty Leinart, Brady Quinn, Rob Stone, and Reggie Bush.
I need that picture, by the way. I keep saying it every time I come up
That's
here.
And I'm nice.
Like, where do I look? I tried to Google it. I couldn't even find it.
Look at that. That is tight. So I got a couple running back questions.
Yeah.
Number one, Zeke, Las Vegas. There's nobody around him. He's by himself. There's no security.
Yeah.
What do you make of the trouble, and what do you make of him?
Well, that was what you just said, because I watched the video, and I'm like, wait, who's with him? Like, he's just wandering around at EDC, and he's by himself. And listen, my boys would never allow me to be in an event like as big as EDC, wandering by myself. And, you know, clearly, you know, him and his the girl he's with got into it, and any kind of pushes the guy down. And it's not like, you know, he barely touched the guy, but it's the spectacle of it, right? And it's the spectacle of him having to get handcuffed after that.
Did you, when you went to events like this, at the peak of your stardom,
I was always with a group of people.
Always
with a group
security?
Of people. Security? Security sometimes too, depending on where we were at. I've been to EDC before with a group of people.
Yeah.
I would never go to something that big like that, especially where he is right now. I just read an article that said they wanted to make him the highest paid running back in the history of NFL. And you think about that. Think about all the great running backs that have come before you. Just think about the one that came before you in Dallas, right? DeMarco Murray. I thought DeMarco Murray was playing great football, and Jerry Jones got rid of him, right? Emmitt Smith, Walter Payton, Marshall Faulk, Barry Sanders, the list goes on. And they want to make you the highest paid ever. And this is now what we turn on and we see. So to me, he needs help, because I've always, for the last couple of years, I said that Zeke is the best running back in the NFL.
Yeah,
because the guy doesn't get hurt. Like, and it's not because of lack of touches or carries. He is extremely durable. And I've been through injuries after injuries with way less touches than him. And so finding a running back like Zeke to be able to produce like he does, as consistent as he does, and not get injured and still be great, and now they want to make you the highest paid, and this is what we see. To me, he needs an OG in his ear. And he needs Irv. He needs Michael Irvin. He needs a guy who's been through a lot and who still has been able to, you know, beat the odds and still has been able to do well with life after football. To me, he needs a guy like Michael Irvin in his ear. And I'm not saying Michael Irvin is not already in his ear, because I've had the pleasure of working with Irv last couple of years, and I know he is a voice for that team for a lot of times for guys when they go through things. And so I think he just needs an OG in his ear to set him straight and make him understand that, listen, it's a privilege to play in this game. And if you mess up this opportunity, it's not coming back to you, right? When the NFL is done with you, it's gone, right? And I remember when I got cut, the first time I got cut, that woke me up. I was like, wait, you guys are cutting me? Like, when I was in Detroit? Because I felt like I had good years to play. And, you know, when teams stop calling, it's a tough pill to swallow, man.
You also had an interesting perspective on Todd Gurley.
Yeah.
A story Jay Glazer confirmed this week. Gurley's got some arthritis in his knee, and the Rams are concerned. How did that land for you?
Everybody has arthritis in the NFL. Every running back, every player, nobody goes through this game without arthritis. I had microfracture surgery after my third year in the league. And writers would say that he's probably got another 2-3 years left. I ended up playing another seven years, you know? And so to me, it's just a matter of Todd Gurley. You know, where is his pain tolerance? Because you are not going to escape this game without pain, without any kind of having to play through torture or whatever it is. And Todd Gurley, he gets a lot of carries. He sees a lot of touches. I love what they did by bringing in C.J. Anderson last year, because that took some pressure off of him. I think that can be a good route to go. Find another back to complement him so he doesn't have to take the bulk of the carries, right? And so that you can keep him relatively fresh for the postseason. And that's where you want to – that's the ultimate goal, I think, for most coaches is how do I keep – my best guys healthy for the postseason.
Yeah, I mean, New England, basically, if you watch New England, September's experiment time,
right.
Post-Thanksgiving when they lock it all in.
Right.
So, no, I
agree. Use four running backs.
No, I'm always reluctant to pay running backs a ton. I do think if you have a rookie quarterback like a Sam Darnold or a Baker Mayfield, and you can give a guy a weapon for like 2 years. By the time Le'Veon Bell's contract's done, you got to pay Darnold. Yeah. Jared Goff. Yeah. I think I would pay the money for Gurley while Goff is young, but at some point you got to pay Goff, and I don't want my backfield having the two biggest contracts.
And finally, that's the same situation for the Cowboys.
Absolutely.
Same thing.
So let's go to this. Richie Incognito, who I've had on the show, we confronted him about some
of his
stuff.
Go?
You know what? It was like T.O. I confronted him. He pushed back. Yeah. At the end, I liked him. Mm-hmm. It's like Baker. I confront him. He pushes back. I'm not looking to win stuff. I'm like, here's what I said. Hammer on me. Let's be adults, and I'm not going to hide from it.
Yeah.
So Richie came out, and I thought he did well for himself. He had a very rough year last year mentally. Mm-hmm. He got signed by the Raiders. I don't know what the Raiders' plan is. This is a – there's some real young players.
Yeah.
There are Vontaze Burfict disruptive players. Like, when you heard the signing, you've played with Richie.
I played with Richie, and, you know, just seeing that combination of Burfict, A.B., Richie, and at the end of the day, you know, you want – like, Richie's a great player on the football field. Great player. He's as mean as hell. I love running behind him when I was in Miami. I played with him for 2 years. I had my two most productive years of my career running behind Richie Incognito. So I think he's a great player on the football field. And obviously, you know, but just having that combination with Burfict and then A.B., and I don't know if A.B. and Burfict still have beef from the hit where he almost took his head off.
Yes.
And then you had Richie in there, and all I can think of is, man, I hope Hard Knocks has the Raiders this year. Like, I hope it has to be the Raiders this year. Like, I don't want to see no other team on the Hard Knocks other than the Raiders.
I think my biggest problem with the Raiders is I tend to like teams that have a plan and I can see it. Like New England.
It doesn't seem like they have a plan.
New England, everybody's taking a cut. Mm-hmm. We're not making any. Even Tom Brady takes
a
cut.
Even Brady takes a cut.
Colts, it's all about we're not going to bring in Le'Veon Bell. Yeah. Anybody with a little wiggle that we don't like, it's team. Rams, by the way, are all into free agency and big personalities. Mm-hmm. I'm okay with that if that's your culture.
Exactly. It just seems like there's no direction or culture right now because they let go of one of the best defensive players of all time.
And then overpaid for Trent Brown. I don't get it.
To the choir right
now. Reggie Bush, College Football on Fox. That'll be starting up in September. Good seeing you, bud.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. Lively last hour. Rick Bucher, Nick Nurse, Toronto Raptor head coach. Good stuff. Reggie Bush played golf with Tiger this weekend. I'll get to that next time. We'll see you next hour.